The laser, regarded as one of the toughest classes on the Olympic sailing program. For three highly respected laser sailors on that circuit, an Olympic silver medalist amongst them, they stand out in the fleet. Not only are they from different countries and competing against each other, they are close friends and training partners.
Hi, my name is Pavlos Kontides. I'm from the beautiful island of Cyprus and I'm sailing lasers.
Boom! Hi, my name is Tonči Stefanović and I'm from Croatia. I'm sailing lasers.
Hi, I'm Karl Martin Ramo. I'm from Estonia and I sail lasers.
The trio travel and train together, and when they get precious time off, you guessed it, they spend it together.
We're here with Tonči and Pavlos, and we have a day off today from sailing, and we're gonna go up to see the Christ Redeemer. Looks awesome from the water. Hopefully the view from up there is awesome as well.
The three sailors made their Olympic debut in London 2012. Ramo took 18th overall, and Stepanović narrowly missed the medals, finishing fourth. But Kontides wowed his home nation by taking the silver medal and becoming the first Cypriot athlete to ever win an Olympic medal for his country.
We've already been in Rio, but this is our first time going up. Should be fun.
It may be considered bizarre to team up and share secrets with rivals from another country. But for these three, all from small sailing nations and without fellow laser sailors in abundance to raise their standard, they have had to go further afield.
Then the only way to improve and have a high standard is to have good people around to train with. And by doing that, we achieve that, and we have the big plus that also during the games, we have guys to train with and we don't have to search for other people.
The life of a traveling athlete, although glamorous and exciting, can be a lonely and costly existence. But this trio seem to have cracked that too.
You always have someone by your side to have a second opinion. If you want to go somewhere, it's boring to go alone. Plus, of course, they travel together, we share the expenses, and in some facts, it's cheaper.
But not every time, but sometimes we are arguing.
Competitive guys, all of us, and if there is an argument, everybody thinks he is right.
If it's some big problem happen on the water, the major losses of points.
Usually I would say it's regarding rule issues. Everybody knows how tricky the rules of sailing can be, so.
Once you launch, you forget the friendship part, and we get to be rivals, and once we're back on shore, we get to be friends.
Yeah, all of us are aiming for the highest possible, and that's the sport, that's the spirit, and that's what it's all about, competing. Hopefully at the end of the day, we have big smiley faces by having more of us on the podium, and that's also the goal of the coach.
Athletes learn the ability to push themselves beyond their comfort zones. To do so, it is essential to see what their competitors have to offer and push even harder.
If you don't bring your A game on a daily basis at trainings, you're just going to lose. And us all being competitive guys, we want to win all the time.
Both of them are really pushing every training, so I have to push also a lot to be better than them, because always I'm trying to be better than them.
So you have to push this extra amount every day, day in and day out, to be even on par with the other guys.
We don't have distance or time to know if we jump longer or higher, or if we run faster, and always sailing conditions are different. You need other boats to compare your speed, and that's what it's all about, to train hard every day and try to improve.
All looking to improve on their last Olympic performances. Come the end of Rio, we will discover if training with their friends is the way to beat their rivals.